Russia and China are considered to be near-peer rivals of the U.S. Russia, under President Putin, has seen a resurgence when it comes to military hardware. It's taken up many promising programs, which include stealth bomber, PAC-DA, stealth drone, Okhotnik-B, and stealth fighter, Sukhoi Su-57. Chinese have managed high economic growth in the last two decades and have devoted a large amount of resources to its military. It's also carried out large-scale espionage and reverse engineering of Western and Russian hardware and is now in a position to churn out many things indigenously. It's touted its Chengdu J-20 as one of the leading fighters in the world. In case of conflict, the Su-57 and J-20 are expected to have a confrontation with F-35s, and the result will have a very big impact on the overall outcome. But F-35 has a trump card, which will play a critical role. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why ANAAQ electro-optical DAS in F-35 will make sure no Chinese or Russian jet will be able to counter it in combat. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by the free-to-play military vehicle combat game War Thunder. We talk a lot about military vehicles on this channel, but what about trying them out for yourself? In War Thunder, you can choose from more than 1,200 playable vehicles from the 1930s to the 1990s and go to battle on more than 80 theaters of war. You can fly aircraft, helicopters, drive tanks, and command ships of all types and sizes, which have been carefully recreated from their real-world counterparts. It's available as a free download on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. So grab your friends and give it a try. All viewers of Defense Updates that register using the link in the description below will also get a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time as a bonus. The Lockheed Martin F-35 Lightning II, which is a single-seat, single-engine, all-weather stealth multi-role fighter, is undergoing final development and testing by the United States. The Pentagon began the F-35 program in 2001 with an aim to develop a cost-effective replacement for the U.S. military's F-15 fighters, F-16 and F-18 fighter bombers and reconnaissance aircraft, and A-10 close-in support warplanes. The F-35 has three main models: the conventional takeoff and landing F-35A, CTOL, the short takeoff and vertical landing F-35B, STOVL, and the catapult-assisted takeoff but arrested recovery carrier-based F-35C, CATOBAR. Apart from the United States, the primary customer and financial backer, the United Kingdom, Italy, the Netherlands, Canada, Austria, Norway, and Denmark are also a part of the program. Many other nations like Japan and Israel are also deploying the fighters. These major partner nations, including the US, plan to acquire over 2,000 F-35s through 2035, which, if delivered, will make the F-35 one of the most numerous jet fighters. On the 2nd of August 2016, the US Air Force declared its first squadron of F-35A fighters combat ready. The fighter aircraft is expected to remain in service till 2050. The ANAAQ 37 Electro-Optical Distributed Aperture System, DAS, is the first of a new generation of sensor systems being fielded on the Lockheed Martin F-35 Lightning II Joint Strike Fighter. The ANAAQ 37 DAS is designed and produced by Northrop Grumman. DAS consists of 6 high-resolution infrared sensors mounted around the F-35's airframe in such a way as to provide unobstructed spherical 4-pi Stradian coverage and functions around the aircraft without any pilot input or aiming required. The DAS provides 3 basic categories or functions in every direction simultaneously: missile detection and tracking, including launch point detection and countermeasure queuing; aircraft detection and tracking; situational awareness, IRST, and air-to-air weapons queuing; imagery for cockpit displays and pilot night vision, imagery displayed onto the helmet-mounted display. The F-35's DAS was flown in military operation exercise in 2011, has demonstrated the ability to detect and track ballistic missiles to ranges exceeding 800 miles, that's 1,300 kilometers, and has also demonstrated the ability to detect and track multiple small suborbital rockets simultaneously in flight. A DAS test system has also been used to track tank gun and mortar fire. So the F-35 can track a plane, produce a weapons-grade firing solution, and fire its missiles without using the very powerful AN-APG-81, which is an active electronically scanned array AESA radar system. Viewers may note that once a radar is scanning in active mode, it can be picked up by enemy sensors. Hence, the DAS in F-35 also plays a critical role in preserving the stealth characteristic of the jet. The Russian Sukhoi Su-57 has 101 KSV infrared search and track systems, and J-20 is thought to possess a DAS. The core of the DAS is the high-resolution infrared sensors. Both these countries lag behind when it comes to this. As per most observers, while F-35 can detect and track a heat source, like a ballistic missile, at a range of almost 1,000 miles, the Russian can do it at a range of only around 100 miles, or 161 kilometers. The quality of tracking is also superior in F-35, as it's able to create a 3D trail. The situation for the Chinese jet is expected to be even worse than Russians, as they have limited homegrown R&D. J-20 is actually derived, to a large extent, from stolen F-35 design documents. For example, NSA, or National Security Agency, of the United States, concluded that the Chinese compromised key components of F-35 that include AN-APG-81 active electronically scanned array radar, methods used by the turbine to cool gases emitted by F-35's engine, as well as other heat reduction techniques. But, as in most cases, it's hard to place the bits of the puzzle in the correct position if you don't have a deep understanding of the overall picture. The important point is that not only is the DAS able to collect the information, but the sensor fusion of F-35 makes sure that the data is easy for the pilot to consume so he can take proper action. At the heart of this is the sensor fusion engine that processes the myriad data the F-35 collects with its different sensors and combines it into a holistic picture. The F-35's cockpit has a single screen that's able to show the relevant information in a concise format due to sensor fusion. As clear from the view of other cockpits, we see there are multiple screens that work independently. Sensor fusion is one of the key features of a fifth-generation fighter, and it's clear that the F-35 is way ahead in this regard. This will be critical when it comes to the air-to-air engagement, as an F-35 pilot will be in a better position to leverage the advanced technologies present in the jet. It's also to be noted that F-35 can share the data so that the situational awareness of every warfighter present in the vicinity is increased exponentially. Last year, a record $34 billion deal between Lockheed Martin and the Department of Defense was reached. The multi-year contract has laid out plans for the jets to be delivered in lots, the first of which will be 157 jets. The contract will reduce the price of F-35A to around $80 million per jet. Undersecretary of Defense for Acquisition Ellen Lord had said in a statement, "This is a historic milestone for the F-35 enterprise and marks the largest procurement in the history of the department." He added, "I'm proud to state that this agreement has achieved an estimated 8.8% savings from Lot 11 to Lot 12 F-35As. While the F-35 production is ramping up, both Su-57 and J-20 are in low-rate production, and the order size is way less. So it's clear that F-35 will have a number advantage, apart from the fact that it's technically superior, especially because of the massive edge the DAS provides. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.